For the third time in 6 years, the Blackhawks are Stanley Cup champions.
Speculation about Blake Coleman here, but a trade is finalized and he is off to Tampa Bay.
Barkley Goodrow, he was acquired in a trade that the Tampa Bay Lightning made just yesterday with the San Jose Sharks.
And escaping back up the wing is Stamkos. He scores!
The story of how the Lightning captured the Cup is perhaps one of the best tales to tell. I personally grew up watching the team from 2015 to 2020, and from the outside looking in, they were chokers. People would always count them out, and never gave them a real shot to win. As a Flames fan, my mind always goes to 2004 when even mentioning the Lightning, but honestly, you can't sit here and say that they didn't deserve this victory. Almost 5 years of pain led to Tampa winning the Cup in the hardest of fashions. So, being that this core has been around for almost half a decade, where exactly do we start? Where did things start to look up? And what made them finally hoist the Cup? Well, for that, let's go to the summer of 2017. This was the year where Tampa didn't even qualify for the playoffs and changes had to be made. Jonathan Drouin was apparently frustrated as he knew he couldn't break out Tampa Bay, so with defense being a team need, Yzerman flipped Drouin to Montreal for Mikhail Sergachev, and this actually made a lot of sense. Sergachev would automatically be protected due to the expansion draft looming, and he had a great rookie season as well. Sergachev would be mentored by Anton Stralman at first, but a year later at the 2018 trade deadline, Tampa would acquire a star talent to add to the blue line, which really had an impact on Sergachev. Tampa would acquire defenseman Ryan McDonough from the New York Rangers for a huge package, which included Vladislav Namestnikov and more. And right away, McDonough would drastically improve the defense. Sergachev would begin to mimic McDonough's style of play, using his size and strength to create separation. These two moves would be a turning point for Tampa Bay, as when Stralman hit free agency in 2019, Sergachev would move into the top four, and Tampa would look solid headed into 2020. But that's not all, as that summer of 2019 would be huge for Tampa Bay, ultimately becoming one of the stepping stones in the Lightning winning the Stanley Cup. At the time, guys like Matthew Joseph and Anthony Cirelli were taking the next step and becoming something great for the franchise. So, Tampa only added two depth signings with Luke Shen and Patrick Maroon. Luke Shen has always been a solid 5th to 6th defenseman, and Pat Maroon had both experience and a recent Stanley Cup victory. Maroon's playoff experience is what lured Tampa in, and he wouldn't disappoint. But these moves would pay off beautifully, but perhaps it was during and before the trade deadline that really sealed the deal, as Tampa would sign both recently bought out Kevin Shattenkirk and Zach Bogosian, creating a deadly blue line which already featured Hedman, McDonough, Sergachev, and Shen. Shattenkirk's impact was huge, as he had a big bounce back season impact-wise alongside of Hedman, and Bogosian would prove to be a great addition, especially come playoff time. At that year's deadline, new GM Julien Brisebois made some, at first, questionable decisions, as Tampa would spend two first-round picks on Blake Coleman from the Devils and Barclay Goodrow from the Sharks. These moves are questioned, as you could argue both players weren't worth that much value. But what I find extremely amusing is that at the time of the trade, Blake Coleman was second in scoring on New Jersey, and once arriving in Tampa Bay, they made that same guy a depth player. Goodrow and Coleman would solidify Tampa's bottom six, and the team looked finally complete, next to no holes. If they were to win a cup, this had to be the year. And just when things were looking up, we have a pandemic, and this would put the league on pause for an entire 3-month period. But Bettman had a plan, and that plan involved making this postseason in a bubble. This would officially be the hardest playoffs to win in NHL history. The NHL announced that it would return the play with a 24-team playoff format, and the top 4 teams in each conference would compete in a round robin to decide seeding. Teams 5-12 in each conference would battle it out in a best of 5 series to make it into the playoffs. Luckily for Tampa, they didn't have to worry about play-ins, but what wasn't lucky was that, once again, Tampa would be without their captain. Stamkos got injured before the pause in February, and was still not healthy enough to partake in the team's playoff run. So, once again, Tampa will be short of a man during a playoffs where it's really anyone's game. And, well, to make matters even worse, who would they have to play in round one? The Blue Jackets. The team that embarrassed them last year in a 4-0 sweep. All was up in the air, and many had Columbus once again stunning the Bolts. But that's until one man emerged as a true game changer, shifting the series after a game 1 5 overtime miracle.
Now Kucherov fires again, hit Gavrikov up high, and a chance of points score!
After this goal, Point only continued to heat up, and the guys around him did as well. The Bolts would take down Columbus in 5, and this was yet again after another overtime dagger by Braden Point. The Lightning were buzzing, as they would take down Boston in 5 games as well, taking advantage of a Tuukka Raskless Bruins team, winning that series in, you'll never guess, overtime. But there's one guy we haven't mentioned who played a ginormous role in the success of the Lightning this postseason, eventually taking home the Conn Smythe Trophy. Victor Hedman has been the backbone of this Tampa team for years, and his impact is felt when he's both on and off the ice, as Tampa struggles to win games without him. But this time around, the Lightning would reap the benefits of Hedman, as he would etch himself in the record books. Throughout the entire playoff run, Hedman would tally 10 goals, the third most by a defenseman in playoff history. While Hedman was tearing off the record books, the Lightning would once again find themselves in the Eastern Conference Final, and in typical fashion, Anthony Cirelli would bury the overtime winner and would send Tampa Bay to the Stanley Cup Final, where they would face an extremely underrated Dallas Stars team. The Stars, backboned by career backup Anton Khudobin, would have a dominant road to reach the finals. They knew this was going to be a challenge right away, as Dallas would take a 1-0 lead in the series in Game 1. That is, until the Lightning would win the next 3 games, and perhaps it was due to a momentum boost, as injured Lightning's captain, Steven Stamkos, played in Game 4 for a total of just 2 minutes, only taking one shot. Well, the impact was that that shot was a goal, and this would potentially be the turning point in that series, shifting all the momentum in Tampa's favor. The Lightning would keep it close with Dallas for the remainder of the series, and the Stars would actually steal a game in double overtime, but it was in Game 6 where Tampa showed that they truly wanted it more.
They haven't gone that in a while.
Here's a shot by Point, save, rebound, score! Point! Power play goal! 1-0 Lightning! Maroon dropped it on back, a feed across on Coleman, scores! Blake Coleman makes it 2-0, Tampa Bay!
5 years of pain, agony, and ups and downs led to this moment.
And the Tampa Bay Lightning have won the Stanley Cup!
This symbolized an end of an era in which a core group of guys would battle it out, only to painfully come short. An era where underachieving was the normal, and a tragic injury or fluke would almost always end their season. The Lightning were never supposed to win. They were always supposed to disappoint. This win would symbolize the end of that choking. All the fire Coopers and trade Stamkoses would be no more. The Tampa Bay Lightning are your Stanley Cup champions, and this time, unlike last time, everyone can finally agree that they truly deserved it.
I want to see everyone. All the flashlights. Come on. Come on. There it is.